Hello everyone. Now here we are going to discuss some few points about our facial nerve, in which we will discuss about the pathway and some clinical lesions which can occur if any type of injury occurs in our facial nerve. So let's begin with the pathway or the course, which can be our intracranial and the extracranial. Intracranial means that at the pathway inside our skull, that is in the cranium. Now the nerve, when it goes outside the cranium, that is when it reaches our face, then we say that pathway is extracranial pathway. Okay, so now this nerve is actually a mixed nerve, and it contains all three fibers: sensory also, motor also, and parasympathetic also. Now let's see where these fibers, nucleus, are present. So in the rhomboid fossa, actually in the rhomboid fossa, that consider it as rhomboid fossa, and it has three nucleus. So just blue one will be your motor nucleus, and red one will be consider as a sensory nucleus. And sensory nucleus of facial nerve has a special name, that is nucleus of solitarius tractus. So it is nucleus of solitarius tractus. Solitarius tractus. And this is your motor nucleus. Motor nucleus of facial nerve. And the third is our parasympathetic nucleus. That is, it has also a special name, superior salivatory nucleus. So we mark it is with a black color. So this is your superior salivatory nucleus. So now from here, and these nucleus are at the level of lower pons. So actually the facial nerve is present at the level of your lower pons. So from here, it has two roots actually. So first root is actually our motor root, and second root is our combination of sensory and parasympathetic. So from here, consider it as your, it is as your motor root, and this is your mixed root of sensory and parasympathetic. It has a special name. This is your motor root, and this is your intermediate nerve, and this we can also say it as proper facial. Proper facial nerve. So as soon as these two roots progresses further, and they reaches opening in the middle ear, that is our internal acoustic meatus. That is the entry place of this nerve into our cranium. So further, as these fibers moves, so this is your, this is your internal acoustic meatus. Internal acoustic meatus. So just near the internal acoustic meatus, there is a ganglion, that is cell of nucleus, and that is the neural bodies. One ganglion, that is your geniculate ganglion. What is this name of the ganglion is? Geniculate ganglion. And this ganglion is actually a sensory ganglion, and it contains the fibers of our taste sensation, which is supplied by our facial nerve. Further we will see how the sensory fibers progresses. So from here, geniculate, as it enters the internal acoustic meatus, that is we have entered in our cranium. Now this is our intracranial course pathway till we exit from our cranium. Now the these fiber, both fibers, so from here it gives a one nerve fiber, that is our greater petrosal nerve. petrosal nerve. And further, as this nerve progresses forward, it joins another nerve, that is lesser petrosal nerve. And by this, these both nerves in combination, we say it as median nerve. By combining these two, we say these both as median nerve. Now, what actually this greater petrosal nerve supplies? So this actually carries the parasympathetic fibers. That is, after going further, it forms a ganglion. That is our parasympathetic ganglion, and this ganglion name is actually sphenopalatine ganglion, or you can say it as pterygopalatine ganglion. Pterygopalatine. Now, what parasympathetic secretion at this greater petrosal nerve supplies? So let's see. So now it supplies our lacrimal gland. And our nasal glands and our palatine glands. So all these three gland secretions are controlled by our facial nerve, that is lacrimal secretion, nasal secretions and palatine secretions. So this is the, and this nerve fibers is actually called preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. Now after further we will, this is the other side of our parasympathetic fibers. Now the main course of our facial nerve. Now from after entering the internal acoustic meters, it bends a little bit, this motor root, and our sensory and the parasympathetic roots now goes further inside our middle ear. Now as it reaches a little inside the middle ear, again it gives a branch. The motor root gives a branch to our stapedius muscle. This is one of the muscle of our ear ossicles, stapedius muscle, motor supply it is. And now further from here, as this nerve progresses, before exiting from our cranium, it gives one another branch, that is our cauda tympani, and it contains our sensory fibers and parasympathetic fibers. Okay, now greater petrosal only contains your parasympathetic fibers, this contain your both fibers. Now at the level of infratemporal fossa, this cauda tympani, let me make it as cauda tympani. At the level of your infratemporal fossa, it is joined by our lingual nerve. Lingual nerve joins the cauda tympani here at the level of infratemporal fossa. Now further it progresses, and our parasympathetic fibers again forms a ganglion. Actually two ganglions, one is for your sublingual gland and one is for your submandibular gland. So these ganglions are actually sublingual and submandibular. And by the name it is clear that what it supplies our secretion of submandibular, that salivary secretion, sublingual gland, and it supplies our secretion of submandibular gland. Now further, the sensory fibers actually supplies our anterior anterior two-third of your tongue. That is the taste sensation of our anterior two-third part. So this is a sensory secretion, and this is linked with genicoid ganglion, that is only our sensory ganglion for our taste fibers, contains taste fibers and controls our taste sensation. Now we are completed with our parasympathetic and sensory innervations. So just consider it as our preganglionic. These are also preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. Now only we are left with our motor root. As a first branch, it has given to us tapetius muscle, which are one of the muscle of our ear ossicles, and further it exit now from our stylomastoid foramen. This is your stylomastoid foramen. It is present on our temporal bone. This is the exit place from our cranium. Now this from where we enter our internal acoustic meatus, and now we are exiting from our stylomastoid foramen. That is, we are just this pathway was actually our intracranial pathway. Now after exiting from the stylomastoid foramen, now we are entering our extracranial pathway. That is, we will see the supply to our facial muscles and some more muscles of our suprachoroid or occipital muscles like occipito frontalis. Now this is your stylomastoid foramen. So this is the exit place for our facial nerve from the cranium. So from here, firstly we will discuss the main motor innervation. That is, enters our parotid gland, consider it as our parotid gland. It does not supply any type of secretion to parotid gland. It's only a pathway that it enters the parotid gland and supplies our facial expression muscles. So now it has two branches. First one is your temporofacial, and second one is your cervicofacial. Now further, temporofacial is divided into our two branches, that is your temporal branch and your zygomatic branch. Now cervicofacial is divided into further three branches. First one is your buccal branch, second one is your marginal mandibular branch, and last one is your cervical branch. So all in one, these branches actually supplies facial, that is motor facial expression muscles. So this is one of our main motor innervation of our facial nerve. So now further two, three muscles also supplies. So between this parotid and a stylomastoid foramen, this first are is your posterior auricular nerve. This is the motor nerve, the motor branch of facial nerve, and it supplies your a muscle of occipito frontalis. Occipito frontalis muscle. And another branch is your muscle to our posterior belly of digastric muscle. Posterior belly of digastric. This is the suprachoroid group of muscles of our neck, and another suprachoroid group of muscle is our stylohyoid muscle. As we know that from embryology, this facial nerve is originated from our second brachial arc. So if any question comes about the muscles, that which muscle is derived from our second pharyngeal arc or brachial arc, So all muscles like stapedius muscle, occipitofrontalis muscle, posterior belly of digastric muscle, and stylohyoid muscle, and all facial expression muscles, all facial facial expression muscle like armentalis, orbicular oculis. Okay, so these muscles all are originated during the embryology from the second pharyngeal arc or second brachial arc. So this was actually our full intracranial and extracranial pathway or facial nerve. Okay, so now we will discuss one clinical point about the facial nerve. Clinical point is one syndrome which occurs when any type of injury occurs in your facial nerve. So with that syndrome is called as Borgard syndrome, or it is also called crocodile tear syndrome. So what happens in this syndrome is that if any type of injury occurs, so this fibers which are supplying to your submandibular and sublingual ganglion, it regenerate, but after regeneration it does not supply your sublingual and submandibular gland. It goes to the greater petrosal nerve and supplies your lacrimal gland. So due to that, while you eat, there is secretion of lacrimal, that's tears fall when you eat. Saliva is also secreting, but with saliva from your eyes tears are also secreted. So this is the clinical condition which occurs when there is injury. So regeneration of facial nerve occurs. And it causes, and instead of supplying your submandibular and sublingual, it supplies your lacrimal gland, which causes secretion of tear while eating. So if any type of paralysis, next clinical we can, any type of paralysis occur in a facial expression, so your facial muscles got paralyzed, neck paralyzed, and just one way to like your face move towards one side. These are all the paralysis which occurs in the lesions with your facial nerve. So this was the full pathway of our facial nerve. So thank you.